Hey there, welcome to Trending on Eniola Badmus TV. Here's the trending story for today. Senator Buruji Kashamo is dead. Details in just a little bit. A former Nigerian senator, Senator Buruji, who was a member of the 8th Senate, has died of COVID-19 complications at the First Cardiology Consultant in Lagos. This was first disclosed by Senator Ben Murebruce via his Twitter handle. He said, "I have just lost my good friend of forever to COVID-19. Until his death, Senator Buruji Kashamo and I were inseparable. He died today at First Cardiology Consultant in Lagos. May his gentle soul rest in peace. I pray for his family and loved ones the fortitude to bear this heavy loss." Senator Buruji Kashamo served as a senator representing Ogun East in the 8th National Assembly under the People's Democratic Party, PDP. He joins a list of prominent Nigerians who have succumbed to the coronavirus. Some of the other prominent Nigerians who have died of COVID-19 include former Chief of Staff to President Muhammadu Buhari, Abba Kyari, and former Governor of Oyo State, Abiola Ajimobi. Although Kashamo's family is yet to issue an official statement regarding his death, but there have been so many condolence messages going out on social media from prominent Nigerians to politicians and members of the society. In case you do not know who Senator Kashamo is, let's tell you a little bit about him. Buruji Kashamo was born 19th of May 1958 and he died 8th of August 2020 at the age of 62. He was a Nigerian politician who served as a senator representing Ogun East in the 8th National Assembly. Ogun East covers 11 local government areas including Ijebu North East, Ijebu North, Ijebu Ode, Ijebu East, Ikene, Odogbolu, Remo North, Sagamu, and Ogun West Side. He was born in Ogun State, Nigeria, and he started his education at Ansaruddin Primary School, Ijebu Igbo, and left in 1972 to complete his primary school education at St. John Modern School, Lagos. He then attended evening classes at Igbobi College while working as a licensing agent. He later went to London where he took courses in business management at Pitman College, London. According to some reports, Senator Kashamo began life in the Butimeta area of mainland Lagos as a bus conductor. According to that report also, his wealth are said to have attracted the attention of the National Drug Law Enforcement Agency in 1995, when the then chairman of the agency, Major General Musa Bamayi, personally led his men to seal off his ginseng mortars on Allen Avenue, Lagos, during a clampdown on some suspected car dealers on allegations of money laundering and hard drugs-related offenses. Kashamo allegedly escaped miraculously from NDLEA detention cell and fled to Benin Republic, where he relocated his businesses and invested heavily in what was described as the largest cotton granary company in West Africa, in which he allegedly conned the Berenice government of his investment. Senator Kashamo is a man that was surrounded with several controversies, and his controversy began from his origin to politics and then business concern. While he claims to be Nigerian from Ijebu Igbo, Kashamo is also said to lay claim to being from a royal family in Benin Republic. He was generally described as a man of many names, having been associated with several nomenclatures in social circle. He is known as Esho Jinodu or Esho Ekun or Omo Jinodu, literally meaning Esho the Tiger or Son of Jinodu. His entry into political landscape was swift as he stormed the Ogun State PDP sometime in the year 2005 during the reign of Olusegun Obasanjo as president, using the vehicle of his Omo Ilu Foundation with a flurry and backed by a huge support received through his philanthropical moves. With his philanthropical act, he founded a foundation with empowerment programs that was very popular in the Ijebu axis of Ogun State. Through the Omo Ilu Foundation, he gave opportunities to his people in the form of cars, skills acquisition equipment, and funds to support and improve the welfare of party members. Also through his uncompromising style of politicking, he claimed the glory of truncating the tenure of Prince Olagun Soye Oyinlola and Engineer Segun Oni, both former governors of Ekiti and Osun State, as National Secretary and Southwest Zonal Chairman of the party respectively. He was also able to cripple the political machineries of political old horses and self-acclaimed godfathers and then positioned himself as a de facto heir of Southwest PDP and the Duke of Ogun politics. That, however, pitched him at loggerhead with the former President of Nigeria, President Olusegun Obasanjo, with whom he claimed to have once aligned to put former Governor Gbenga Daniel in political disarray. He went on to contest the Ogun East senatorial seat and beat his closest rival with a poll of 99,540 votes against Prince Dapo Abiodun of the All Progressive Congress, who pulled 84,001 votes to clinch the senatorial seat. He was the flag bearer of the People's Democratic Party in the 2019 Ogun State gubernatorial election, which he lost against Dapo Abiodun of the All Progressive Congress, coming in distant fourth. He was a chieftain of the People's Democratic Party (PDP) in Ogun State and was appointed as the Chairman Organization and Mobilization Committee of the People's Democratic Party in the Southwest Zone of Nigeria. In 2018, he was expelled from the People's Democratic Party, a decision later voided by an Abuja High Court in October 2018. The flip side to the controversy surrounding Senator Kashemo was in 1998 when he was arrested in the United Kingdom on drugs-related charges after trying to enter the country with $230,000 in cash. He was acquitted and released in 2003. British authorities refused a U.S. extradition request on drugs charges, citing concerns about his identity. However, Nigerian authorities announced their intention to deport him to the U.S. on multiple occasions. Olusegun Obasanjo, a former president, warned that his ongoing freedom illustrated that drug barons will buy candidates, parties, and eventually buy power or be in power themselves. Well, it is clear that there are so many things to say about Senator Kashemo. But one thing you need to know is the fact that Senator Kashemo died the exact same day his mother died in 2019, that is, the 8th of August 2020, while his mother died on the 8th of August 2019. Eniola Badmus TV has footages from the mother's burial, which was well attended by prominent personalities in Nigeria. Let's check it out. So many people have sent out their condolence messages, and one of such that shook the internet is definitely the condolence message from the former president of Nigeria, Olusegun Obasanjo. The letter of condolence says, "I received the sad news of the demise of Senator Esho Jinadu Buruji Kashemo, a significant citizen of Ogun State. Please accept my condolence and that of my family on this irreparable loss. The life and history of the departed have lessons for those of us all on this side of the veil. Senator Esho Jinadu Buruji Kashemo, in his lifetime, used the maneuver of law and politics to escape from facing justice on alleged criminal offense in Nigeria and outside Nigeria. But no legal, political, criminal, social, or even medical maneuver could stop the cold hand of death when the creator of all of us decides that the time is up. May Allah forgive his sins and accept his soul into our Jannah, and may God grant his family and friends fortitude to bear the irreparable loss. Yours sincerely, Olusegun."